Hey y'all. In this video, I'm going to take a couple of steps back and we're going to get back to a couple of the basics, especially in dealing with closed vectors. I've had several requests here lately. Several folks have emailed me with problems, and I've seen several posts in some of the Facebook CNC groups about closed vectors when it comes to V-carving, and we're talking strictly about the VCarve toolpath here. So I'm going to use a situation one of these posters has asked about in one of the Facebook groups, and we'll go ahead and get into the project and I'll demonstrate how to fix the issue. So we'll go ahead and create a new file. Now the size of the drawing is not really important in this video. The techniques are more important. So I'm going to go ahead and accept whatever is in here. It's a single-sided job with a 12-inch width in X and a 12-inch height in Y. My material thickness is 3/4 inch. I'm setting my Z0 position at the material surface. And for layout purposes, I'm setting my XY datum position to the center. Now we'll go ahead and click OK. And I have my material set up. The instance that one gentleman posted about was having a problem with is he wants to V-carve the area between two circles, but he wants to carve them in quadrants. So I'll go ahead and set up the file the way he had it, then show him how I would fix the issue. Then I'll get into an alternate method. So what we'll do is we'll come over here under Create Vectors and we'll go to Draw Circle. I want the center point of the circle on my X0, Y0 right here in the middle of the material. And for my outside circle, I want a diameter of 8 inches. And I'll click Create. Now without leaving the form, I want another circle inside of that one. So we never discussed sizes. I'll just make it easy for you to see. We'll go with a 7.5 inch diameter circle inside that. We'll click Create. Then we'll close that circle, or close that form rather. So there we have our circles. Now what he was attempting to do was divide these two circles, this space in between the two circles, into quadrants. And he did that by coming up here under Create Vectors to Draw Line Polyline. Click on that and come up here and you'll see how my cursor changes. It snaps to the center and gives me that crosshair and tells me that I'm on the X0 line, which is what I want. So I'll click my left mouse button to set my first point, come down below the inside circle, click it again to set that point, then hit the space bar to set that line. And I'll do that on all four corners here. We'll snap and then click again, space bar, then snap to the center line, click, click again, space bar, then snap to the center line, click, click, space bar. So I have my four lines here. And I'll close that form. Then come over here under Edit Objects to my Interactive Trim Tool. Select that icon. Make sure that I have Rejoin Trim Sections automatically when the form is closed. And come up here and just trim. So that I'm leaving that line in between the two vectors. Trim. And trim there. Okay, now I can close my trim tool and zoom everything to the center of my screen. Now this is as far as he got. He tried selecting it all, going over to the toolpath tab and doing a VCarve toolpath, and this is where he got the error that there were four open vectors that were going to be ignored. The toolpath that it created just carved out the circle in one piece. He now knows that these four lines are still open vectors. And none of the join tools over here would join them. And the reason for that is simple. You cannot join an open vector to a closed vector. You can only join an open vector to another open vector. So you could get into node editing mode and cut the vector and join this, that, and the other, but there are simpler ways of handling this. I'm going to show you the first way, which is to use an offset. Now, this gentleman and I never spoke. I don't know how much of a gap he wants between this quadrant, for example, and this quadrant. So I'm going to make an assumption on my part, and let's just assume we want a 1/8 of an inch gap between the end of this quadrant and the beginning of this quadrant. What we'll do is we'll offset this line here that we just created. So with that line selected, I'll come down here under Offset and Layout, and I'll click on Offset. Now, again, we never discussed any spacing or anything like that, but let's say I want a 1/16th of an inch gap between these two quadrants here, and I want that all the way around between the quadrants. I'll show you how to do it on one first, then we'll do it on the others. We'll do multiples. With that one selected, I want to offset both inwards and outwards. So I want to create a line to the right and to the left of this line. I want a 1/16th of an inch gap here, so I'll change the distance to 0.03125, or 1/16th of an inch. I'll leave that create sharp offset corners checked because I do want the corners to be straight up and down. And I'm going to select delete original because once I have the line to the outside and to the inside, I no longer need this vector. Then I'll click on offset, close. Then when I zoom in here, you can see that I now have this line 1/16th to the right, and this line, or excuse me, 1/32nd to the right and 1/32nd to the left. Now, it's a simple matter of trimming those two vectors there that we just created. And we have our first quadrant, the separation between the two quadrants. Now, to do multiples at the same time, I'll zoom back out, center my piece here, and I'll do a box select of these three lines all at once. We'll go ahead and draw from left to right. Make sure my box completely surrounds all three of those lines, and that's all. Then when I let go of my mouse button, it selects those three lines. I'll go back up here to offset and layout. I have the three selected. I want to do both. Keep the same measurement. Delete original. Click offset. Now I can close that form, grab my trim tool, come in and snip, snip, and just do that all the way around. And there we go. And using the offset tool like this, you can set whatever gap you want in here. Just know that when you do select the offset, whatever distance you put in here, that's the distance it's going to be on each side. So if you want a gap in here of a specific width, cut that width in half, and that's the number you'll put here. Okay? That's the only thing to remember. Now, what if you don't want a gap in between these vectors here? What if you want to get this as close as you possibly can? Well, there's another way of doing that. And that's a little bit more complex, but it just depends on the look that you're going after. So we'll go ahead and we'll select all of these vectors here, delete them, and I'll start from scratch. So we'll come along and we'll start with the 7.5-inch diameter circle, create. Then I want an 8-inch circle, create, close, come back up here to draw a line, and we'll do this again. And the bottom, this side, and close. Come back and trim the vectors. And there we go. Now we're back to this stage here. To keep the gap between each quadrant as narrow as possible, what we'll need to do is create closed vectors here for this quadrant, and then closed vectors down here for this quadrant. Well, these little short lines in here can only be used for one quadrant. In order to get a quadrant over here that uses this same line, we'll need to copy them. So this is when we start using layers to our advantage. Now, if I go up here right now and into my layer manager and click, I have one layer. What I'm going to need to do is copy this entire drawing. So I'll select everything. Then come up here over one of the vectors, it doesn't matter which one, right click, copy to layer, new layer. That's going to open up the Add New Layer dialog box. I'll leave the layer name, Layer 2. The color, I'll leave it alone. I don't want the new layer visible. I don't want the new layer active. So I'll uncheck both of those boxes, if they're checked, and I'll click OK. Now when I come up here to my layer manager, I have Layer 1 and Layer 2. Layer 2 is turned off. Layer 1 is in bold, so that's the active layer. Now, this is just a simple matter of doing some trimming. I want to create this quadrant right here. So I'll come back to the interactive trim tool here. I'll make sure I have rejoin trim sections automatically when the form is closed. I'll make sure I have a check mark there. Then I'll trim away this vector here, those two there, and then these two up here. What I've done on layer one is I've created this quadrant and that quadrant. And we click on this, we can see we have two closed vectors. Now I can turn off layer one, I can turn on layer two, double click it to make it active, so any changes I make are affecting this layer, then turn off layer one, then come back and trim these vectors over the quadrants I've already created. So we'll trim those two, close. Now when I come back up here and turn on layer one, I have closed vectors all the way around. So now to VCarve this, to see what the final result would be, I'll select this vector, hold down shift, select that vector. We'll go over to my Toolpaths tab, and I'll select a VCarve engraving toolpath. I have a 90 degree V-bit selected. I'm going to leave that there for this demonstration. I do not want to use a flat depth. I'm going to accept everything as it is. It doesn't matter. We'll make that VCarve 1, and I'll click Calculate. I'll come up here, select toolpath color, and we'll make this one blue so that you can see it. And I'll preview that toolpath, and there we have these two quadrants cut. Come back over to my 2D view. I'll close my preview. I'll select this vector, hold down shift, select this vector. Go to the VCarve engraving toolpath, and again, select, just leave everything as it is, Name that VCarve 2. Calculate. And I will make this toolpath color red so you can see the difference. Then we'll preview that toolpath. And there we see we have four quadrants, different colors. And we can zoom in here and see that there is a tiny sliver of surface material in between these quadrants. That's about as thin as you can get. That's the least amount of surface material that's going to be left behind. There has to be something in there to differentiate this quadrant from that quadrant. So that's how I would solve that problem. By either creating layers and using layers to my advantage to create closed vectors for V carving, if I wanted the tiniest gap between those quadrants, or offsetting this little dividing line, this center vector, outwards to either side by half of my desired gap in here in between. So, as you can see, there's more than one way to skin a cat in this case, and the choice is yours. I tend to refer to this as thinking in VCarve, because the thing to remember, we are so used to drawing a line, in this case, an arc, and then a line, and then an arc, and we think in terms of these vectors. When in VCarving, we need to think in terms of the space between the vectors. So the space here is the line we're actually carving in our 3D preview. And I know that's difficult to wrap your head around sometimes, but just remember when you're talking about VCarving, they have to be closed vectors. And it's the space in between those vectors that is going to be carved away. And again, I'm talking specifically about the VCarve toolpath. So, I hope you got something out of this video. If you did, please give me a thumbs up. And if you'd like to follow along with my further CNC adventures, or if you'd like to keep abreast of the Vectric Software tutorials, I do hope you'll subscribe to my channel. Now, I'm sure some of the more sharp-eyed among you have noticed that I've recently upgraded to Vectric Aspire. Yes, that means there will be some 3D modeling videos coming down the pike as I get better and develop my skills with Aspire. So, we'll go ahead and we'll close out this video right here. And as always, whether you subscribe to my channel or not, I'd like to thank you very much for taking the time to watch. And y'all take care.